Good morning student. Now in this lecture we are going to see about the sorting. So first sorting method is bubble sorting. Now see, if we are going to program for bubble sorting, so now first of all let's understand the program of bubble sort. Now in our first program, here ULIST, that means ULIST is the variable which contains the unsorted list. This is your value of unsorted list: 10, 16, 7, 13, 15, 3, 1. Now we have calculated the length of the our unsorted list. Now n equal to length of the unsorted list, U list. That means n occupied the value of length of the unsorted list. Now for I in range n, we have start a loop I to from I equal to 0 to n. Again we are going to start a inner loop in I for j in range 0 to n minus I minus 1. If u list of j of u list is greater than j plus 1 of u list, then u list j will be equal to u list of j plus 1. See here, and u list j plus 1 is equal to u list j. You can see the program here. This is the your sorting program. Now here print the u list. Now in this line we are going to calculate the find length or size of list. I think you are going to understand the mechanism. Now this is your outer loop. Outer loop up to 0 to n, that means length of the list. Now this is your inner loop. What is the work of inner loop? It will going to complete the comparison for each and every element of the unsorted list. Now here if u list j, that means u list ka j will be started from 0, that means u list 0 is greater than 1. If condition is true, then u list ka j is u list of j plus 1. There is the swapping done. Here we are going to make comparison. Here do comparison. Comparison of element, and this is the part of your swapping. Yep, this is the here is the swapping. Here is the your sorted array. Sorted list. Each new list, and if you are going to print this statement, you can print here this is your unsorted list. Now I hope you are going to understand the comparison. Here 10 is compared with the 16. If 10 is greater than 16, then 10 and 16 will be swapped. That means 16 will take the place of 10 and 10 will take the place of 16. I think you are understanding this thing. Now again this element, this 10 will be the bubble element and this will going to compare with this. Now again here is the bubble element, this will compare with this. Again this bubble element is going to compare with this. Each and every element is calculated like the bubble form. That's why it is called bubble sorting. I hope you have understand the concept of bubble sorting. Now if we are going to check output, here you can see that your unsorted list is 10, 16, 7, 13, 15, 3 and 1. Here your sorted list is 1, 3, 7, 10, 13, 15 and 16. This is the your sorted list and unsorted list. Now if we are going to see for the repeated value, in the case of repeated value, see here now see this is the case of repeated value. That means sorting of repeated values. Now see here we have taken an unsorted list like 10, 16, 7, 3, 7, 3 and 7. Here you can see that 3 will be repeated 2 times and 7 is repeated 3 times. Now we have to calculate the length of the list and same algorithm and same code will be used to sort the list. Now we are going to sort the list. Now if we are going to print the output of this list, you can see that 3, 3, 7, 7, 7, 10, 16. This is the output of sorted list for in case of repeated value. This is your sorted list. And this is your unsorted list. Now see here, if we are going to align this thing, now you can see that here 3, 3, that means these two values are of equal value and these three values are equal. That means if we are going to compare the element, then we are going to check only less than or equal to. We are not going to check equal to. That's why they are same values. That's why first two element, same element are sorted, then next element are sorted, then next. I think you have understand the concept of sorting in repeated value case. So there should be no confusion. If we are going to check in our program, then if we are going to check 3 is greater than 3, here 3 is greater than 3, that means if we are going to check this line, then this condition will be false. this condition is false. That means there is no swapping will be done. That means now the important thing is this, we are going to compare, but we are not going to swap the value. That means number of comparison made here, but there is no swapping of value. So I hope you will understand this concept of sorting. Now our next program is of your insertion sort. Now I hope you have clear understanding of sorting up for repeated value. Now we are going to see insertion sort. Now see this sort. In insertion sort, we are going to take a list and the element will be 15, 19, 54, 12, 19. Here we have already taken two same values. Now print unsorted list, and we have calculated the length of the list, and we have take the loop for I in range 1 to n, t equal to u list of I and j equal to I minus 1. Now what will be done here? In insertion sort, we are going to divide the unsorted list in two parts. First one is sorted and second one is unsorted. Now if we are going to divide like 15 is sorted, then our key will be 15. Now j equal to j minus 1. While j is greater than 0 and key is less than u list j, then here swapping will be done. U list j plus 1 equal to u list j and j is equal to j minus 1, else u list j plus 1 equal to key. Now see, if we are going to store the key element, now key element will be compared with the next element. In insertion sort, we are not going to compare with the all element, we are going to compare with the next element. That means key j plus 1 will be changed into j. If j is greater than 0 and key is less than u list ka j, that means key, if 15 is less than 19, then this will be swapping will be done. Now if else u list j plus 1 equal to key. Now again, if we are going to print the output for this, check the output, see your unsorted list and sorted list. Here you can see that 19 and 19 are repeated. This is the sorting of repeated value. This is the same value, but in your list it occurs two times. Then the Python or interpreter is written it two times, but in the memory there is one value. So now if we are going to check this concept of same value, we are going to check the concept of same value, then if we are going to print here, see, if we are going to print the index of 19, if we are going to print index of 19, now here see carefully what will be done on the Python end. Here we are going to just print the index of 19. This index will be returned of the sorted list, because we have sorted the list. Now this is going to return by the sorted list. So check the output. See, this is the your 0, 1, 2. This is the index of 19. I hope you have understood, because in unsorted list this is the index is the 1, but in sorted list we have to print the value of 0, 1 and 2. That means if you are going to unsort the list, then this index will be returned by the sorted list, not from the unsorted list. If we are going to return this index from the unsorted list, then we have to delete the sorting code. Sorting program jo sort kar raha hai program usko humko delete karna hoga, then the id or index will be returned from the unsorted list. Now see, if we are going to print id of the 19, id is used to return the memory address. Already in previous classes we have studied about the id function. This return the memory address of any item. Now if we are going to print id of 19, then observe the output. See, this is your id and this is your index of 19. Here 19, 0, 1, 2, index will be 2, and id, that means memory location will be this 17, 48, 67, 47, 68. Now if we are going to cross check this line, if again you are going to print the index of 19, because there are 2 19, then see what will be the result. See, again 2 will be written. That means you can say that index of 19 is 2. This is the repeated in your list, not in the memory. Now if we are going to print the id of ulist 2, that means हमारे sorted list में दो टू वाले index पे क्या है, 19 है, 3 वाले index पे भी 19 है. If we are going to print the address of these two, suppose that now we are going to make comment this line. Now see, now here we are going to print the id of 19. 19 is the at the position of 2 and at the position of 3 in your sorted list. So check the output. You can see that this and this will be the same memory address, but there is the two value 0, 1, 2 at the 2th index and at the 3rd index. There is 2, 19, but memory address is same for both, and index is also same for both. This is the concept of multiple values or duplicate values in your list. There are two value in your list only, not in the memory. So I think you have clear understand of multiple values storage, how to going to store multiple values in your list and how it will be sorted in your list. Now if we are going to print id of fourth index, now see 0, 1, 2, 3, 4th, at the 4th index 54 is present. Now the memory address will be changed. You can observe this output. So I hope you have clear understanding of repeated value concept in sorting. If any doubt, then you can ask. I hope this is your best explanation for multiple values. Now thank you for today. Have a nice day.